Yo, what's going on, everybody? Jake here with Venter Visuals, and today I cannot be more excited to be showing you guys these three awesome jitter effects that I use for music videos and just any type of video where you want to make it slap a little bit harder. These three jitter effects are going to make that happen. So let's get into it, guys. We're here in Adobe Premiere Pro, as always. You already know what it is. So here in my timeline, we're going to be breaking down three different examples. So I got my final results, and then I have the second version of all the clips, and these are the clips that we're going to actually create the effect from scratch on. Let's go ahead and break it down, starting with this first effect. So I really like adding little shakes and little flares and little light bursts throughout my music videos, and I think this effect just makes the bass knock a little bit harder. So check this out, guys. But only for the evening. Bitch, I'm popping like right there. So we get this little bright flash, and then this shake transition that you can see, it gets a little blurry right there, and then it's gone. So we're just gonna come over here to our second version of these clips where there isn't a shake transition. So check this one out. So there's nothing going on there. It doesn't slap nearly as hard. The way we're gonna create this shake effect is by first coming over here to our effects tab, and we're gonna type in Luma Corrector. Okay, so I'm gonna put that on this second clip right here. So obviously there's the cut, it goes from black and white, and then boom, there's the cut. So right here, this second clip has the Luma Corrector on it. What we're gonna do is hit a keyframe on the gain, pedestal, and gamma there in the beginning. Then we're gonna come about six frames to the right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and drag those keyframes over, come back over here to the beginning, and we're gonna tweak our keyframe. So I'm just gonna put it pretty bright like that, so we get this nice bright flash effect. Ready? So that's beautiful. All I did was keyframe the pedestal and the gain under the Luma Correctors. The second thing you want to do is come to your project panel and then import an adjustment layer. We're gonna go ahead and hit OK, drag that onto our timeline here. We're gonna go ahead and cut it. It's a lot shorter, easier to see. We're gonna place that right as it lines up. So this is gonna be our shake effect right here. And we want it to last for about, I don't know, 6 to 7 frames. So we're just gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, I think 6 is fine. We're gonna cut it right there. Now we have the length of our jitter effect right there. Now what we're gonna do is go over here to effects. Gonna type in transform, and all you wanna do is drag that on your adjustment layer just like that. And this is how we're gonna wiggle the frame around and actually get that jitter type of effect. So what we're gonna do is just come to the very first part of this adjustment layer. We're gonna make a keyframe on the position, and we're just gonna move this position around going every frame. So every single frame, I'm doing something a little different. You know, you can get as dramatic as you want with it. That's cool. So now we get this shake effect as I scroll through. Now what I'm gonna do to give this like some natural motion blur, I'm just gonna increase this shutter angle to 360. And now you can see we got this blurriness kind of going on, but the last thing you gotta pay attention to are these black edges. So in order to get rid of that, we're just gonna zoom in the scale until those are no longer noticeable. So I'm gonna go ahead and go like 113%. So now as I scroll over it, you don't see any of those black edges. So now when I play this back, it should slap pretty hard on the beats. Check this out. Yeah, so that's pretty much it in a nutshell. It really makes the visual hit a lot harder, especially if the song has like a lot of bass or a big kick drum or anything like that on these beat drops. This type of jitter effect is so dope. So we're just gonna move on now to the second example. All right, so here's the example without the jitter effect. So obviously it doesn't hit as hard, not as cool. We wanna add that little jitter effect in there. So what you gotta do is figure out where that kick drum is happening. So let's listen back to it one more time. So if I zoom in, you can see we got like these two little spikes right here. So I'm just gonna go ahead and make a cut right there. There's obviously one here already because the first part of this clip is in slow motion, and then it goes normal motion right here. So we're just splitting this clip where the kick drum is hitting. And now what we're gonna do is add a Gaussian blur onto both of these. So we're just gonna go ahead and take it on to this first one right now. We're gonna change it from horizontal and vertical to just horizontal. We're gonna go ahead and increase the blurriness, make a keyframe there in the beginning, come all the way to the end, turn it down back to 0. So this way, as soon as the kick hits, it's like maximum blurriness. So it looks like it's hitting with the kick drum. So let's see what this looks like. So obviously you can see it gets blurry there for a very quick second, but it's almost like it lasts too long. And then there's two kicks hitting right here. So what we need to do is just bring this keyframe in so it's a lot quicker. So one, two, three, maybe three frames, that's good. And then what we're gonna do is copy this Gaussian blur onto where this second kick is, which is right here. We're just gonna hit Command C to copy, Command V to paste. And now we have the two jitters like right back to back as the kicks are hitting. So I really like this one because it's a little more subtle and it's easy to kind of just copy and paste it around the timeline. So I hope you guys like that one. We're gonna move on to the third and final jitter effect. All right, so I think this third and final transition is my favorite type of jitter transition. So for this transition, it's gonna look like this. So it's definitely cool looking, especially when you tab over it. It's blurry, it looks like surreal almost. There's this glow effect happening. So I really like using this jitter effect for transitions like this, like right when the beat hits again, like right on this kick right here. So I've got the raw clips right here with no transitions. Let's check that out. So, you know, just pretty ordinary looking, you know, we need to sauce that up for sure. So all we need to do is come back here to the cut. We need to go about 8 frames to the right. So I'm just gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and I'm gonna make a cut right here. So we cut this second clip right as this transition's happening. We're gonna use this first part of this clip to make this effect. All we need to do is go to your effects tab, type in an effect called levels, drag that on. You're gonna make a keyframe on this white input level right here. So we're just gonna go ahead and make a keyframe right there in the beginning. Go about one tab over. We're gonna go ahead and drag that white input level down a little bit. Go one tab over, maybe bring it back up. Maybe leave it like that for 2 frames, then bring it back a little bit. Now you can customize this as much as you want. This is just to like really make this like flash effect look dope. So as I scroll back here, you can see that we kind of got like that flicker flash effect going on with these levels. Now all I'm gonna do is type in an effect called transform. It's under your distort tab, and I'm just gonna drag that onto our little transition clip right here. And now what I'm gonna do is keyframe the position in the scale. So I'm gonna go ahead and keyframe the scale to start a little bit more zoomed in, maybe like right there, the position, you know, move it over there. Maybe like give it 2 frames of like zooming up, moving the position, and then maybe back a little bit. So we're just playing around with like the position and the scale on this transform, okay? And then we're gonna add a little bit of like some motion blur to it. So there we are at the end of our transition. So as you can see, you know, not the smoothest looking transition by any means. So what we need to do is turn on this shutter angle under our transform. We're gonna turn this up to like 360. Now this looks a little bit too much blurry to me, so I might even bring it down a little bit. So you can get creative with this as well and play around with it as much as you want. So let's check this out now that I have it set to about 140. So I like it, but I don't like how it flashes here right at the end. So all I'm gonna do is get rid of the last keyframe for levels. I'm gonna actually bring it back down to normal, so it's a little bit more gradual on that flash transition. So yeah, I think I like that a lot better. Yeah, that's a lot smoother. So there you go, guys. Just a little bit of a combination of the transform and the levels, and then just tweaking some keyframes. Pretty easy stuff right there. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Every like, every comment, every subscriber that I get, I really appreciate everybody who's tuned in and watched some of my tutorials. Thank you guys so much. You guys are the reason that I continue to drop more tutorials. So if any of you aren't subscribed to my channel, definitely consider hitting the subscribe button and following along the journey. We're all just gonna continue to grow this community of creators together. I want everybody to be able to help each other get better at their visuals in this community. And if you're a video editor who's looking to add some sauce to your visuals, check out my website, venturevisuals.com. I got overlays, light leaks, transitions, and a bunch of other stuff on there that is perfect for music videos, creative edits, that sort of thing. So if that's interesting to you, check the link down below. We're gonna have a killer week this week, guys. I'm looking forward to it. Until next time, I'm Jake Venner. Peace out.